Okay. All right. Yeah. Before getting into SAP BW, let's have some small introduction of SAP. So I have just prepared a few of the slides for you to go through it. So SAP is a German multinational software company where it was actually introduced in the year 1972. The headquarters are in Waldorf. You see the company's major product is enterprise software. It manages both the business operations and the customer relationship as well. It has operations in many different modules like sales, materials, you take utility, industry specific, you take oil and gas, you take into medical, healthcare, even in the HR, like payrolls. They have the products in almost all the applications. Okay, and they are the biggest multinational software company around the world. They have many customers. They are the first one to give a tough competition for the enterprise applications, which means enterprise resource planning, which I'm talking about here, which is ERP. So it was actually founded in the year 1972 by former 5 IBM employees. Okay, so SAP stands for Systems, Applications and Products. Their first product was actually launched in 1973, which is Enterprise Resource Planning. Now, I will repeat Enterprise Resource Planning throughout my class. I mean, this is the heart for SAP, for all the products. So before getting into the ERP, I just wanted to give a quick outlook of what is ERP and why it has created a revolution in SAP. So before ERP was been introduced, you see many of the companies, their structure, for example, you take any company structure, you take a company, you have a company, I mean, it might be a retail company, it might be a software company, it might be any other gas, oil, any company, take any company. So the key one will be, for retails, it will be the customer, and for any company, employee is the key primary person for an employee. So in a single company, in any organization, you have multiple departments, whereas in a retail, a customer is the major one for all the departments. In a retail, you take for sales department, for purchasing department, or even for the delivery department. For all of them, customer information is a key one. So everyone needs the customer information. A salesperson needs the customer information to pull out which is the customer who has bought many products from my organization in the last 1 year or 1 month. Similarly, a delivery, I mean, for which customer we deliver the most on time, or even for the some other department similarly. So everyone wanted to have the relationship with the customer. They wanted to maintain the customer database. What happens earlier is every department maintains the customer database with respect to them. Customer database is not centralized in those days before ERP was founded. So what happening is you see a database, customer existing in all the databases, all the departments. How many number of departments present in any organization? So the customer or the employee is getting duplicated here because it exists in different departments. It is not unique. And cost. You have to maintain database. You have to maintain the servers for each and every department. There's a lot of cost involved there. Okay, so that is the drawback earlier. I just wanted to show you. This is the picture. This is what I'm talking about. If you take an organization, you see a finance department, you see HR department, you see a travel department. Finance guys want to see for which employee, what is the salary they want to see. HR department want to see their leaves or their compensation. and travel department want to see their all the travel details. So everyone wanted to see the employee details in respective of their corners. So what happens is everyone maintains their own database here. So an employee, for example, an employee, ex-employee, he is present in finance department as they need to trace out his salary. Obviously, HR employee will definitely be there because HR needs an headcount. And travel department, if the person travels with the company compensation, then the travel department needs that employee. So what happens is this employee exists in all the databases. Ultimately, when a company wants to see the number of employees from the databases, they can pull out the database from three different systems, from these three databases. But what happens is you will get the duplicated data. And again, you are maintaining an employee data in three different databases and three different servers, which leads costs, more costs, because the more servers you have, the more costs you are investing there. So to this drawback was being outcome by the ERP. So what happens in ERP, when the ERP was introduced, they have maintained a centralized component, which means the database is a centralized component for all over the organization or all over the firms. So you have the same database which is accessed by the multiple departments. You have three departments today in your organization. You may have X number of departments when the company, as the company grows forward. As the employer company grow forward, employees grow, so database also grows. So for that, you cannot maintain different X number of servers and keep on exceeding your cost and duplicating the customer or employee data. So your ERP is centralizing your database. So all your departments and other organizations can access a single database. So you design in such a way that all the finance data goes to finance department, all the HR data of an employee goes to HR department, and all the travel data of an employee goes to travel department. So they are receiving their data what they want. In this data, you have a customer has all the data. So this database stores all the department's data, an employee, finance, HR, and travel. All of them will be stored in a single database. But when you are extracting them, it splits the data in the with respect to of the finance department. So that's how you can design. So you can see the cost is obviously reduced because we are maintaining only a single database here. And also there is no duplication here because we are maintaining again a single database. Customer duplication cannot be happened here. This made a revolution and this made SAP to shine more in the in the world. So this is the ERP introduction. So ERP stands for Enterprise Resource Planning. You can see this slide. It is an integration solution that incorporates the key business function of any organization. It's a key, right? Because without ERP, you cannot build any architecture. All the SAP, the modules or whatever the products they have, it is not about the BW, it is something else. Everything is designed on ERP. It's on the base of ERP. So this is a centralized component for your architecture. So it's very important to understand the ERP concept before you come to the SAP BW or any SAP, attending any SAP classes. All right? I hope you might have got some picture about ERP by now. If you have any questions on ERP, you can just raise your point. You can just ping me on the chat. Mm-hmm. Someone says they have some question. Okay, if you have a question, you can speak on. All right. Okay. So now that you might have understood the picture of ERP and before ERP. Now let's come to the actual point now here, SAP BW. So BW stands for Business Warehouse. BW was actually named as BW was actually named as Business Information Warehouse when it was introduced, and later it was renamed to Business Intelligence, SAP NetWeaver Business Intelligence. But that name was not there for a long time because there are some confusions on the customer side, because intelligence stands for the analysis type, where Bob J goes that name. Bob J have a business and intelligence name, so they have renamed it back. They have renamed it back to Business Warehouse. Now, what is Business Warehouse? It is an analytical reporting, extraction, and a data warehouse software. It is a kind of ETTL tool, not just ETL tool. It is a kind of ETTL tool. E stands for extraction, T transfer, T stands for transfer, and another T stands for transform. You're transforming your source format to an target format, because your source might be something else. Your transform might be something else. Your target might be something else. So you wanted to map the objects from your source to your target level. So you are transforming the source format to your target format. So that is called transform. And then L stands for loading. So this is an ETTL tool. You extract the data, you transform them, you transfer them, and then you load them. This is an analytical tool. I mean, apart from this, you can design a report, because BW has an inbuilt reporting tool which is called as Query Designer. So you can design the reports, whatever the data you have in SAP BW, you can design them according to the requirement from your management. So that is where this is called as analytical also, analytical and reporting. And when I say analytical, you can do an analysis basing on the report which is extracted from different systems. You have a report and you show the report to your management. They can see it, because they are running some business and they wanted to know their statistics. Everyone wanted to know their statistics, because the better the statistics, the better you improve the business. So with your reports, the way you give your reports, because for example, they wanted to see, hey, I wanted to see my sales, or I wanted to see the promotion discount, so I gave the promotion discount of particular products, and I wanted to see how does it go, whether it's a hit or whether it is a boom. You can just check that. So with the report, they can analyze, okay, these are the customers who are liking this product more, or these are the things when I give a promotion, which is going on sale, because I have something in my inventory, is loads and loads of material which is there in my inventory. I wanted to sell it them, because that is not a big hit in the people. So I'm giving them promotion of 50% discount or some 60% discount, and it goes fine. So something, I'm clearing my inventory. So this reporting, this will help them in analyze their business a lot. So that is why you say this is an analytical reporting tool. Okay. Now, before going to the flow, you can see that. So before going to the flow, I just want to explain you how SAP BW can bring the data. So for example, you have many different tools in the market. You can ask me why only SAP BW. You have many. You have Oracle. You have ETL. You have MDSS. You have Teradata. There are many different reporting tools. However, SAP reporting tool, this report, it gives you a great analytical way. I mean, the way you design them, if you see the layout, I mean, you agree. It's not just a plain vanilla. You can design the report. You can download them into a PDF. You can download them into an Excel. You can send those reports automatically to the respective email address or to the respective groups. So that you can do lots, many things. But before that, because ETL, you have different number of tools, like you have some SSL, or you have some different tools, like you for extraction you need one tool, for reporting you need another tool, but SAP BW is a single stop for ETL plus your reporting. You can bring the data. It is not only you can bring the data from any corresponding SAP system, you can bring the data, for example, someone is running the business and they are just maintaining the data or their accounts in just an Excel. So what happens, they can write a macro and they can create a report in an Excel. But Excel data, you cannot say that is an accurate data. There might be a human error in the Excel data. When you're entering some data, there might be human errors. You can enter for 200, you can enter 2, or you can enter 2000. So there might be a chance of duplicating data or human errors. SAP BW can extract the data from an Excel or from an SQL system or from any non-SAP systems as well as SAP systems. So you, if you have different data maintained in different landscapes in your organization, you can put all of them into one data warehouse and you can show the reports. Maybe you have two the kind of business, you have some safe business and you have some what do you say, Oracle ERP. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. There are many different kinds of ERPs. It is not only the one ERP, but this is SAP is giving a lot of competition to all of the ERPs. I know Oracle Fusion is released, which is I mean, you can mention all your questions in the end. As Kapil said, I can answer you one by one, whatever the questions you can ask. So there are many different tools. That's what I'm trying to say. Many, it is not only SAP BW. This is not only the ERP system. There are many, but that is where it differs from. That's what I'm trying to say. You can connect the data from an SAP, from non-SAP, or from any other systems. And the data retrieval, it is not just only extracting the data. Any other system can do, but the performance, you want it to. So the management doesn't have a time to sit in front of the laptop and run a report for minutes and minutes, and they wanted to see millions of records. No, it is not like that. Nowadays, everyone wanted to see their report on their tab, on their phones. Everything is in a pocket. So the reporting, the performance, and the design is the most important thing here. So if you have millions of records, for example, a company which is running for maybe last 10 years, they're just maintaining an Excel and they're running the business. Suddenly they heard about SAP and they wanted to implement SAP in their organization. So you cannot just extract the 10 million, 10 years data into the system just like that. There are many criteria. We wanted to see how do they maintain the structure. And how do you extract the data? 10 year data, use huge number of inventory, huge number of sales. There might be millions of records. So the way you design the data to extract all of them into VW is where you will be mastering there. So the performance, the data cannot be taken many hours to load. For example, a million records, it should not take like 30 minutes. The way you design them, you have to use your database level skills here. You have to design the primary keys in such a way that you pull them in a faster way. So those kind of all the fine tunings in SAP were very good. Okay, so you can pull the data from all different systems. You can bring any kind of data, and you can store all of them. No need to worry about the database which is going in the system, because we already maintain them in a source system, which we in SAP we say as ECC system. It is called Enterprise Centralized Component. It is kind of a database. It is not just database, it's a centralized component where all the systems can access that system. It is not only BW, some other system. So we will store the data, SAP will store the data in that ECC system, in a tables level, and from there you will pull all of them to different systems. Similarly, if it is from SQL, you again create a mirror copy of that SQL table in your system, because you don't know what happens if the database crashes, because you wanted to save a mirror copy of your source data in your system all the time. In that way, the data was never lost. And second thing is, you maintain your data continuously. So the more the data grows, you see the more the performance issues happen. You wanted to run a report, for example, and 1 year you wanted to see a sales data, or you wanted to see your inventory. How does your inventory in last 1 year? Inventory data is very huge, trust me. So it will crash your portals if you run millions of records. SAP gives you the reports, but you cannot use it just like exactly. I wanted to see all the 10 years data, how many number of customers, or I wanted to see all the products, something like that. You cannot just extract the data just like that. This is mainly for analysis. Excel thing, whatever you wanted to see the complete data, we have a different number of tools, but this is high-level reporting, high-level analytics. This gives a glance to your managers of your company CEOs. They wanted to see a report. They wanted to see maybe sales for last 1 year. They wanted to see the gross margin. How does it went? They just wanted to see the graph. I wanted to see if you enter a button, they just wanted to see gross margin. of last year and this year. Okay, last year I got this gross margin and this year I got this gross margin. So they just wanted to see a report in a flash, kind of a dashboard thing. They don't want it, they don't bother about the Excel, because they, ultimately they see the final figure, right? Basing on that, they'll take the decision. So those kind of reports you can build many in SAP Variable, and SAP will give you all the standard objects or the standard flow, whatever is needed basing on the business. For example, you take any HR wanted to implement SAP in their organization, our company, because the one we, many companies have like PeopleSoft or Workflow, something as they maintain your payrolls in those kind of applications. There is a module in SAP, even SAP HR, we can maintain it. So SAP will give you the standard of this. If you take HR, the basic thing, an employee, what is the salary of an employee, the joining date, beginning date, promotions, and compensations. So all of his details, his appraisals, everything. So SAP will give you all those information, keeping the business in the mind. If you say, I want to implement HR, SAP HR in my company, so you see all of those standard info objects as the standard object, like an employee is also called as an object in the BW terminology. So all those kind of things are already predefined there. You don't need to do a very extra work with creating all of them from the scratch or imagining what all I need, whom I, how do I design my table. So all these given by SAP. Okay, well, you might have asked me a question like, when SAP gives completely everything, so what is the way, and what point of having many consultants around the world? So it is not just only standard things which run the business. You might need a lot of things to be customized, because whatever SAP gives, they just keep the key things in the mind and they deliver it. For HR, they just keep those kind of employee appraisals, salary, joining date, beginning date, termination, everything, or he's the manager, his peers, everything, they'll maintain it. It is not, there are some, it is not a pre-built report. It is like a standard objects which they give you. Yes, they do have some standard reports, but as I said, they just maintain their standard objects or the standard reports, keeping the key things of any business in the mind, because they cannot go beyond and think of the box saying that, okay, some XYZ business may need this, or some YXY, some business needs this. They just give the whatever the key things needed for that particular area. It is your responsibility, if a company has a complex database or complex structure, you have to design them in a custom way according to your standard, whatever SAP gives you. So that is where SAP gives you a lot more customization as well as a lot more standard things. Okay. Yeah. So if you see here in this flow, this is just like a basic flow you see in any SAP. You can say a small architecture. It is not the complete architecture which I have got here. A small architecture. You see these are all, these two might be SAP. In this picture, we are seeing all the SAP sources, but you can see even like ETL or some other. Even you can extract them using an SQLs. So even from non-SAP systems, so these are, this first layer is your source layer, which is the source system might be an SAP system, might not be an SAP system. You can extract the data from any systems, providing you will transfer them in the way how SAP accepts the data. You cannot just pull out an ETL data, or you cannot just extract an SQL data. You design them in such a way that SAP BW can pull them and store the data. Okay, so that is where this is called a source layer, always. And coming to the EDW layer, this is extraction and data warehousing layer. So you will, here BW comes and sits in this part. You will store all the data from all your source systems, from all your SAP and non-SAP source systems in BW. You store them in different tables. And then you have, for example, we already take an example of a company which runs for last 10 years and they wanted to implement SAP on that, right? So you have already built all those 10 years data, you already pushed them to SAP BW. Now today, while running it, the company never stops. The company is still going on. So the live data is already there. You can extract the live data. You wanted to see last 1 hour sale. I wanted to see what the sale in the last 1 hour. You can quickly extract them. So that is the data acquisition. That is the real-time data which SAP can immediately and show it to the system. And from in a report, you wanted to see, okay, last 1 year, one hour or 2 hours data, I wanted to see today's last two hour sales. You can immediately pull them. So all those deltas, that is called as a delta, your latest records, according of, I mean, you want your historic data, you want your current data as well. So you can pull all of them in a mechanism where you can extract them in such a way that, okay, I wanted to store historic data in some other table, I wanted to load the standard table in some other table, and you wanted to load both historic and as well as the real-time data in the same table. So this is all the tricks which you can do in your designing level. The good the design is, the beautiful the report will be. If you design the report in such a crap way, the report will take maybe many minutes, 10 minutes. If a report takes more than 5 minutes, that's 5 minutes itself is a very huge time, not even one, but less than a minute. So that is how they wanted to see. Now, competition is like that. Every tool is coming up with, okay, I see millions of records, I can extract in maybe some seconds. So all these kind of performances you can design, this all these extracting the data from some other source systems and you keeping them in BW, you're keeping them in a different tables, you maintain them, you partition all the tables, you maintain the database in such a way that it gives a very good performance for you, and you create the reports on top of them. So all this comes in your design level. After your reporting, it will be your analytics purpose. So you give the reports to them for them to see how the reports they want. They management asks you many, it is not only for the managers, it might be for the store managers or it might be for some other below manager subordinates. So again, management wanted to say, okay, you created a report where it shows me all the gross margins of this year and last. It is a very high level data, and management says that's a secured authorized data. They don't want to see that data any of their other employees staff. You can create those reports in such a way that only your management can see. You can create those authorizations even in the reporting level. Or your boss wanted to see, okay, I have multiple plants in one some city. I don't want one specific plant data to be shown to any of the employees. I wanted to keep that very, very specific only to the management level. So in that case, even you can restrict the data for a specific store level or for a specific country level. So all these things are possible in your designing. So that is how the managers will ask them the data. So you can restrict the data according to their requirement. You cannot show, or no one can see just the reports all over whatever design in the BW. You can restrict them. Though it is the same report, you can restrict. I can restrict you to one particular store, and I can restrict the other person to see only another store. So all these beautiful things, you can design them in the reporting level. And here you see, this is where you can transform your source format to your target format. The targets are nothing but your tables, SAP BW tables. So here, in this place, you transfer them from your source format to your target format. And you see all your tables sits here. The info cube terminology is nothing but it's a table again. I mean, once we get into the deeper, I'll tell you what is info cube and what is other things. But technically speaking, it's a table again. And on top of this, you will create your reporting, which is nothing but your queries. I already told you, right, there is an inbuilt reporting tool in SAP BW, which is called Query Designer. So that is where we design our reports. We pull the data from different tables. Even we can combine them. We can merge different tables and pull the data. You can, like, sales, you maintain it in this table. Billing, you maintain in this table, and again shipping details, you maintain in this table. You have multiple reports, even in sales, again on shipping, again on billing. But some maybe management want to see all sales, shipping, and billing in a single report. You can combine all of them, and you can create a single report by merging all these cubes. So, lot many beautiful things. you can design the report. So once you design your query, you can publish them. It is not like you, okay, you created a report, you tell them, you publish them in like a portal nowadays or in a GovJet. So you give them a link where BW reports will be in a single place. You give them all the sales reports, all your finance reports, all your HR reports, everything. So whoever have the authorization to execute the report, they can execute the report. Otherwise, they cannot. You can restrict any user for accessing particular data and particular reports as well. That is how it goes. So if you wanted to see a sample, I just try to manage you to show you some sample data, how it looks like. This is not exactly, this is a report, but this is just a layout which I showed you. So this is how it looks. You can, for example, for calendar day, this day, what is my materials? And this is kind of the sales data. And what are the articles or materials which is sold, and what is its value, what is its quantity, whether if it has any promotional value or not. You can see all this kind of data. That is how it looks. You can see, you can drill down them, you can play around. You don't want it to see, you just wanted to see the material groups and the articles and what is its value. You can do that. User can do it on his own. That is the way you design the report. You don't need every user say, okay, I need a separate report where I don't want it with a material group. I just want it to see with a calendar day and an article and a sales value and quantity. So you don't need to design another report again. You will give them a flexibility where they can design themselves, in the sense, okay, I don't want this. I want only on materials and articles along with the sales value and quantity. Or they just wanted to see only the articles. So all these, you will give them an access and a flexibility where they can design themselves within the report. So you create a report, and whatever the flexibilities they want, they use, they play around, and they just look at the report. So this is how it works. Okay, I hope, I think I give you a brief introduction about an SAP, ERP, and how it works in the business point of view and the reporting point of view, extracting the data from source systems and non-source systems. So if you guys have any questions here, you can bring me now.